I first met Stanley about 3 years ago in London. I went to see his band and I never thought I could have a chance to play with him. So it's just like a dream come true for me. And it's so improvisational. You know, we come in studio, we talk, we see how we feel like, and just really focus on what could come out from the person today. And, you know, having such a conversation with jazz giants is just amazing thing for me. Sakura is one of the probably most well-known Japanese traditional song. And the melody is so simple, so that's why we can really put different harmony and chords to it, and it has such a freedom, just like the cherry blossoms. When I played the song with Stanley and Lenny, I was very proud of my culture, and I was very happy that, you know, this song is played by legends like that.
Stanley was 18, 19 years old. I was playing with Joe Henderson, and I was 20. And I went to, Reggie Johnson was playing bass. And so Reggie decided to go to California to become a studio musician. So we needed a bass player. So I went to Slugs, a club in New York. Howard Silver was playing. And I walked in and I heard this guy playing electric bass. So he came to the bar after and I introduced myself and I said, Joe Henderson needs a bass player. Here's his number, you should give him a call. And he called and we've been playing since. This was 1971, around 1971, something like that. You know, I grew up with him musically, and he's become such an accomplished musician. I mean, he was always a great bass player, always phenomenal talent on the bass, but he's become such a great musician. I mean, like with all of the different things that he's been doing, and it's Stanley Clarke, man. This is my first time playing with HIROMI, and her playing, you know, just the piano, and it's really great, man. I think this is a nice departure from the other things that I've heard, and it's pretty special. I mean, and you know, the fact that Stanley and I have played together before kind of makes an interesting bed for her to play on, and I think it's pretty special.
I was actually inspired to do an acoustic record this time, mainly because many people that have known me in the old days knew that I started out playing acoustic bass. I'm actually really an acoustic bass player slash electric bass player. I got all my popularity, I'd like to say, from the electric bass. I mean, this happens. Sometimes the business doesn't necessarily correlate with what the real musician is, you know. But, you know, I have a tremendous love for acoustic music. I mean, when I grew up, that was the music that I really, you know, was drawn to. This is a nice time to do a record like that, because one of the things I like about being at this point in my life is I don't particularly feel, you know, like I have to necessarily do any one thing, you know. And, you know, lately in the last 3-4 years, I've been doing a lot of acoustic playing live, playing with the Rite of Strings, with Di Meola and John Luponte. And even in my own bands, half of my set is acoustic. And so this was nice, you know. So I've always wanted to play with a HIROMI, and I love playing acoustic music and jazz music, particularly with Lenny White, because Lenny really understands the language. You know, it's one thing to play acoustic jazz music because you have the instrument that sort of goes with that, but there's another thing is actually understanding the language, which requires knowing a little bit about the history, so you kind of know what records to listen to and learn from when you're young. And Lenny's that guy. He's like a history book on jazz if you really sit down and talk to him. And so he has, you know, he plays the cymbal the right way. He has the right cymbal when he plays with the brushes. As far as HIROMI's concerned, I mean, she has all the right notes and she plays nice, and, you know, she's really like a team player, because playing acoustic jazz is a lot like being on a basketball team. It's a team playing. In order to swing, you know, everybody has to swing, you know, and that's sort of the common denominator that runs through all that music, where the clave is, where the swing is, and then everything that else that happens is just kind of gravy, as they say, you know.